There's so many interesting and unusual species or systems that we're working to protect. Things that are mostly unnoticed to the average person outside. A lot of the work we're doing is to try to support a good system, a good forest that's already making progress, it's growing, it's expanding, or restore the species that you would expect to find on a forested slope.
In Ohio, prior to European colonization, species of oak, hickory, ash, American elm, and American chestnut once covered much of the state. But by the turn of the 20th century, many of Ohio's woodlands were felled to make room for agriculture and other development. Although many of the Appalachian forests of Ohio have come back from the brink due to conservation efforts, poor forestry management practices today are gradually diminishing the quality of our reestablished forests.
Depending on who you are, you have a lot of different definitions for what makes a forest a good, healthy, quality forest. For us, as a conservation organization, we're focused on wildlife habitat. We're concerned about the future conditions of those stands and the development pressures. But I would say that what makes a good, healthy forest is having your trees that are going to be there today, and then they're going to be there 150 years from now, in a condition that provides the most complexity of wildlife habitat, ecosystem services like clean water, clean air, carbon sequestration. To maintain healthy forests, to create healthy forests, there needs to be some level of active management. And one of those methods is actually going in and doing some intentional thinning, some ecologically based, mindful removal of trees. The way that many of our stands are progressing, it's going towards a maple poplar dominated forest condition. The canopy is just too dense to allow sunlight to hit the forest floor for oak seedlings to successfully go from a little seedling fresh out of an acorn all the way up to mature overstory tree. They just need more light than they're getting.
Oaks and hickories produce nuts, a food source for many species like squirrels, turkeys, deer, and birds. Not only do they produce these nuts, but oaks actually capture more carbon than any other native tree species. In the summer months, oaks host a large variety of caterpillars for both butterflies and moths. Migratory birds, as well as bats and other animals, will live off of the insects residing in the oak canopies. Without oak trees, the diversity of food available for native species would diminish dramatically.
So if we don't do management now, the oaks won't be there, and then we're gonna have a bunch of maples replacing them. And those are native species, but they just don't provide the same ecological value that oaks and hickories do within our forested systems.
By following a forest management plan that encourages the growth of more mature trees, landowners can receive income by increasing the forest carbon capturing power, making our forests a key solution to fighting climate change while supporting our local communities. Partnership is essential. The ownership of Ohio's forests is highly divided, making it critical to empower these private landowners with the tools and incentives to restore their forests. The story of Ohio's forest is one of regeneration and hope. To join us in the fight against climate change and biodiversity loss, visit nature.org/OhioClimate to learn more and get involved.